In this video, we'll study about the histology of the cardiovascular system. The cardiovascular system consists of heart and the blood vessels. The blood vessels that take the blood from the heart to various tissues are called arteries. The smallest arteries are called arteriole. The arteriole open into a network of capillaries that pervade the tissues. Exchange of various substances between the blood and the tissues takes place through the walls of the capillaries. In some situations, the capillaries are replaced by slightly different vessels which are called as sinusoids. The blood from the capillaries or from the sinusoids is collected by small venules that join to form veins. The veins return blood to the heart. The blood vessels deliver nutrients, oxygen and hormones to the cells of the body and remove metabolic waste products and carbon dioxide from them. Next, we'll see about the endothelium. The inner surface of the heart and of the blood vessels are lined by flattened endothelial cells, and these cells are also called as endotheliocytes. On surface view, the cells are polygonal and elongated along the length of the vessels. The cytoplasm is sparse. The cytoplasm contains endoplasmic reticulum and the mitochondria. The microfilaments and intermediate filaments are also present and they provide mechanical support to the cells. Many endothelial cells shows invagination of the cell membrane on both internal and the external surface. Sometimes the internal and the outer invagination meet to form channels passing right across the cells, which is seen typically in small arterioles. So these features are seen in the situation where the vessels are highly permeable. Adjoining endothelial cells are linked by tight junctions and also by the gap junctions. Externally, they are supported by a basal lamina. So when you see the functions of the endothelium, apart from providing a smooth internal lining to the blood vessels and to the heart, the endothelial cells perform a number of functions. As the endothelial cells are sensitive to alteration in the blood pressure, blood flow and in its oxygen tension in the blood. They secrete various substances that can produce vasodilatation by influencing the tone of the muscles in the vessel wall. They produce factors that control the coagulation of blood. Under normal conditions, the clotting is inhibited. When required, the coagulation can be facilitated. Under the influence of adverse effect, example by cytokines, the endothelial cells undergo changes that facilitate the passage of lymphocytes through the vessel wall. In acute inflammation, the endothelium allows neutrophils to pass through the blood into the surrounding tissues. Under the influence of the histamine, which is produced in the allergic states, the endothelium becomes highly permeable, allowing the proteins and the fluid to diffuse from the blood into the tissues. The resultant condition of accumulation of the fluid in the tissue is called as edema. The changes in the properties of the endothelium described above takes place very rapidly, that is within minutes. Next, we'll see the basic structure of arteries. The histological structure of an artery varies considerably with its diameter. However, all the arteries have some feature in common, which are: the wall of an artery is made up of three layers. The innermost layer is called as tunica intima. The tunica intima consists of an endothelial layer. So first is the endothelial layer. Next you have the thin layer of glycoprotein which lines the external aspect of the endothelium, that is called as the basal lamina. Next you have a delicate layer of subendothelial connective tissue. Next you have a membrane which is formed by the elastic fibers that are called as internal elastic lamina. So these structures forms tunica intima. The tunica intima is formed by the innermost layer, that is the endothelial layer. Next to that you have a basal lamina. Next you have the subendothelial connective tissue. Next you have the internal elastic lamina. So the endothelium along with the basal lamina with the subendothelial connective tissue and the internal elastic lamina forms the tunica intima. Outside the tunica intima, there is the next layer, that is the tunica media or the middle layer. The media may consist of elastic tissue or smooth muscle depending upon the type of the artery. On outside, the media is limited by a membrane which is formed by the elastic fiber. So this is called as external elastic membrane. The outermost layer is called as the tunica adventitia. This coat consists of connective tissue in which collagen fibers are predominant. This layer prevents the undue stretching or the distension of the artery. The fibrous elements in the intima and the adventitia run longitudinally along the length of the vessels, whereas those in the media, the elastic tissue or the muscle, they run circularly. The elastic fibers, including those of the internal and the external elastic lamina, are often in the form of fenestrated sheets. On the basis of the kind of the tissue that predominates in the tunica media, the arteries are often divided into elastic arteries, which are large and conducting arteries, the muscular arteries, which are medium sized arteries. The elastic arteries include aorta and the large arteries which supplies the head and neck and the limbs. The remaining arteries are muscular. Although all the arteries carry blood to the peripheral tissues, elastic and the muscular arteries play differing additional roles. Next we'll see about the elastic artery. When the left ventricle of the heart contracts, the blood enters the large elastic arteries with considerable force, and these arteries distend significantly. They are able to do so because of much elastic tissue in their walls. During diastole, the relaxation of the left ventricle, the walls of the arteries come back to its original size because of the elastic recoil of their walls. This recoil acts as an additional force that pushes the blood into smaller arteries. It is because of this fact that blood flows continuously through the arteries. The elastic arteries are also called as the conducting vessels, as their main function is to conduct the blood from the heart to the muscular arteries. So when you see the structures, first is the tunica intima. The tunica intima is made up of endothelium, subendothelial connective tissue and the internal elastic lamina. The subendothelial connective tissue contains more elastic fibers in the elastic artery. The internal elastic lamina is not distinct from the media, as it has the same structure as the elastic membranes of the media. Next is the tunica media. The media is made up of mainly of elastic tissue. The elastic tissue is in the form of series of concentric membranes that are frequently fenestrated. In the aorta, which is the largest elastic artery, there may be as many as 50 layers of elastic membranes. Between the elastic membranes, there is some loose connective tissue. Some smooth muscle cells may be present. The tunica adventitia. So it is relatively thin in large arteries in which the greater proportion of the elastic fibers are present. These fibers merge with the external elastic lamina. Next we'll see about the muscular artery. A muscular artery has the ability to alter the size of its lumen by the contraction or relaxation of the smooth muscle in its wall. The muscular artery can therefore regulate the amount of blood flowing into the region supplied by them. Hence, they are also called as a distributing arteries. So, when you see the structure of the muscular artery differs from the elastic artery in having more number of smooth muscle fibers in the tunica media. The transition from the elastic to the muscular artery is not abrupt. In proceeding distally along the arteries, there is a gradual reduction in the elastic fibers and increase in the smooth muscle content in the media. The tunica intima, the internal elastic lamina in the muscular artery, you can see clearly the internal elastic lamina in the muscular artery because it stands out distinctly from the muscular media of the smaller arteries. The tunica media is made mainly up of smooth muscle fibers, and this muscle is arranged circularly. Between the groups of the muscle fibers, some connective tissue is present, which may contain some elastic fibers also. Longitudinally arranged muscle is present in the media of the arteries that undergo repeated stretching or bending. Example of such arteries are coronary arteries, carotid arteries, axillary artery and the palmar artery. Next is the tunica adventitia. Next we'll see the clinical correlation. Atheroma. The most common disease of the arteries is called atheroma, in which the intima becomes infiltrated with the fat and the collagen. The thickenings formed are called as atheromatous plaques. Atheroma leads to the narrowing of the arterial lumen and consequently to reduced blood flow. Damage to the endothelium can induce coagulation of the blood, forming a thrombus which can completely obstruct the artery. This leads to the death of the tissue supplied. When this happens in an artery supplying the myocardium, which is known as the coronary thrombosis, it leads to myocardial infarction, which manifests as heart attack. In the brain, the cerebral thrombosis leads to a stroke and paralysis. An artery weakened by atheroma may undergo dilatation, which is known as aneurysm, or may even rupture.